We know that the characteristic distinguishing property of alkali metals are reducing ability and their flame coloration. The reduction potential and the reducing ability depends on the combined energy difference of the three processes, that is sublimation of the atom, ionization to the metal ion, hydration of the ion with water. Lithium being the smallest ion, its hydration enthalpy is very high than others and compensates more than its higher ionization enthalpy. Thus, it increases from sodium, then potassium, rubidium, cesium and lithium. Flame coloration in S-block elements, the energy needed for an electronic transition between the available energy levels falls in the visible spectrum region. That's why they give a distinguished color on heating and they produce a characteristic color to the flame reflective of their emission or absorption spectrum and can be used for their identification. But why are melting and boiling points of alkali metals so low? Because being very soft, alkali metals have low melting and boiling points compared to the other periodic elements. Melting points and boiling points decreases from lithium to cesium. Now we see that the other properties of compounds of alkali metals. They are their chemical properties which changes because of their being very highly electropositive elements and they form compounds which are of ionic nature. So the different compounds of alkali metals and their general characteristics such as hydrides, nitrides, oxides and hydroxides we'll discuss. Alkali metals react with hydrogen at high temperature to form metallic hydrides. Metallic hydrides releases hydride ions. Then nitrides are formed when alkali metals react with atmospheric nitrogen. Similarly, when they react with phosphorus, they form phosphites and water hydrolyzes phosphites to phosphine. pH 3. Then oxides are formed when they burn with oxygen, but the nature of oxides in each element is different. In some they form simple oxides, in some they form peroxides, and the lowermost elements form the superoxides. So smallest element, that is lithium, it forms normal oxide, sodium forms peroxides, and the other larger atoms form the superoxides. Lithium Li2O, which has oxidation number of oxygen, that is -2. Sodium oxide has peroxide, has oxidation number of oxygen, that is -1. Potassium, rubidium and cesium superoxides have oxidation number of oxygen, that is -1/2. Since the alkali metals react with nitrogen, oxygen, water in the air, they are always stored under kerosene. Now we see the chemical properties of hydroxides of alkali metals. The reaction of metal is exothermic and the enthalpy increases from lithium to cesium. Alkali metals float on the water during the reaction. The density of sodium and potassium are lower than water. In heavier alkali metal, reaction enthalpy is high, so that metal gets melted and raises to the surface. Hence, the reaction with water becomes very fast, extremely highly exothermic and explosive, leading to the fire from lithium to cesium. The reaction shows here that it reacts with water to give hydroxide ion, metallic ion, hydrogen is released and enthalpic energy, that is due to highly exothermic reaction. With the largest electrode potential and high hydration energy, lithium is expected to be very reactive and highly exothermic. Instead, lithium reaction with water is slow and not explosive. Lithium has higher ionization energy and more covalent than rest of the alkali metals ions, so its solubility and the amount reacting will be limited. Cesium is ionic and soluble in water. Now we see that the enthalpy of reaction is higher than that the latent heat of fusion. So the cesium melts into liquid, increasing the amount reacting, leading to more reaction as a cycle. Alkali metals can replace hydrogen from any proton donor molecule like alkyne, ammonia, alcohol, etc. Now chemical properties. Oxides and water react with water to ultimately yield the hydroxides like lithium hydroxide, sodium hydroxide yields hydrogen peroxide also, potassium hydroxide along with hydrogen peroxide and oxygen. This represents the type of particular oxide which is formed when the oxidation previous reaction we have seen. Now carbonates and bicarbonates are formed when hydroxides are alkaline and they react with carbon dioxide to give carbonates, and these carbonates are ionic, they are thermally stable and water soluble, and these properties increases from lithium carbonate to carbonate. Bicarbonates except lithium bicarbonates are solid, water soluble and on heating liberate carbon dioxide. Similarly, we'll see the properties of sulfates, nitrates and halides. Sulfates are soluble in water except lithium sulfate. Sulfate can be reduced by carbon to sulfides, forms double salts with trivalent metal sulfates which are called alum. Nitrates are soluble in water and on heating except lithium nitrate decomposes to nitrites and liberate oxygen. Halides, alkali metals react vigorously with halogens to form solid ionic halides with a definite crystal structure. Reactivity decreases from fluorine to iodine. Lithium halides are an exception with more covalent bonding because of the high polarization of a small covalent ion on the electron cloud of the halogen anion as indicated by the Fayan's rule. Lithium halides are insoluble in water. Halides of bigger metals form polyhalides by combining with more halogens like potassium iodide combines with iodine to form potassium triiodide.